I brought out the range with me today. Is a 50 caliber trade rifle by Lyman. It's the first new firearm I ever bought while I was waiting for my PAL. And in Canada, you don't need firearms license or anything like that to own or shoot a flintlock rifle. Now, the exact same gun and percussion cap, you gotta have your PAL, you gotta have all the liberal stuff to own one of those. But because of the firing mechanism is flint, and rumor has it, because of doctors and lawyers doing reenactment, you don't have to register these guns. So, as you can see, nice flintlock. It's a 50 caliber, like I said. And I'm gonna give a quick lowdown on how to load the thing, and I'm not going to dwell on that. I'm mostly going to shoot. So I've had this gun for quite a few years now. I just finished putting a new frizzen and new flint on her. I had to part cleaned her up a bit, and much to my dismay, there was a little bit of rust in the barrel, but not much I can do about that now. But she's pretty accurate. I'm going to use round ball and patch, so anyway, I'll stop flapping my gums and get at her. Okay, I'll make this quick and painless. To load these, pretty simple. You got your measuring tool. It's measured in grains, and the grains for black powders by volume, not weight. Read the manual so you don't overload these things, and never put smokeless in the muzzle loader. For a flintlock, you're going to need the pan primer. So this little fellow's full of powder, and when you push down, of course, the black powder comes out. I use 4F in the pan. I've used 3 in a pinch. It works, but it's a little bit slow. And you're going to need your starter. Ball starter, little brass gets are started. This drives you down about 4 inches into the barrel. Of course, in the end, you use the ram to send it home. And of course, you get a flask here. This is 50 cal, so I can use 3F or I can use 2F. And I'm using 90 grains of 2F. And of course, you gotta have your patches. These are pre-lubed. I'm gonna give them a try. Most of the time I just use spit patch, so I just throw a patch in my mouth. By the time I get the powder and everything in her, stick the patch over the muzzle and put the ball on, and away you go. So first off, I'll load up the measuring tool. Did a couple of rounds with this Yukon Gold. There's two problems with that stuff. One, it's so coarse, it won't even go through the spout. That's their 2F. I have no trouble with their 3F. Their 2F, you need a shovel if you're going to use that stuff. Alright, so now you just put the you want to wait a minute or so between shots too, because you got a spark in there. You're going to be pretty excited. I got a little thump that helps the powder settle down into the breech there. Okay, powder's in. Center of the patch, over the end of the barrel. I'm using 490 round ball. Throw that around, won't we? Now, these come with a wooden ram. I replaced it with this composite one just because I don't think it feel good. Just, you know, I haven't really heard of anybody doing it, but it breaks. And the downside is it's pretty wobbly, so you gotta kind of, I put my hand over the end of the barrel, because if you push down, it can pinch. It can give you a little pinch. to get her home. Make sure the ball's seated all the way in. You do not want an air gap when you're firing black powder. And you could have pretty explosive results if you do. Now, because we have a flinter, we'll pull it back half cock, frizzen's open. You don't fill the pan. I find that two presses is good enough, about half full. I just level it out a little. You can see there, without dumping it all over the place. Close the frizzen and you're ready to shoot. And it's not a good idea to pull this all the way back. Now you've got it half cocked. You see she won't go. Of course the barrel's downrange just in case it does decide to go. You just never know. All right. That's it for loading the flintlock. Like I say, use the amount. Don't exceed what they recommend, please. And never use smokeless powder and muzzle loaders or any other gun that was really originally designed for black. Another thing about flintlocks, you're standing and shooting, make sure nobody's standing on the flint, the action side of the firearm. So most of them are on the right. You don't want anybody standing here. As you might know, there's a little hole basically going into the chamber. Well, when you light this thing off, there's a lot of hot gases come sailing out that little burner hole there. So you don't want anybody standing on the action side of these flint logs. It's probably remove somebody's sideburns or mustache that way. All right. This takes a little getting used to. You get this big flash going off in your right eye. It's next to, it'll take a few shots. It's been a long time since I shot this thing. Not to blink when you squeeze her off. These are a lot of fun though. Unfortunately, everything's wet, so I can't see my usual plume of dust just to find out where these balls are going. I managed to put one ball in the target. Seems to be a little to the left. See, that's the gun or me. Might have to, probably me. See, you get quite a flinch when you first pull that trigger. Again. And I gotta say, I'm hitting the paper. I'm not really holding very high. So, just be patient when I pull the trigger, I'd probably do a little better. Love all that smoke. It's great fun. Yeah, you can see that from here, but nailed it three times. I went to get some more of these targets and they're all out. So I'm stuck with putting masking tape on it. But I'll set her up there so we can see the ball going in. Get a kick out of that. These things are a pile of fun. see a few of them lately on Canadian Gun Nuts website for sale. I got, we have 4 muzzle loaded rifles, so I don't really need another one. But need's got nothing to do with it. I think it boils down to want. Too much fun. Love that smell. I guess I'm going to shoot 200 and also clean her up a bit. You know, messy old black powder. Have a lot of fun though. Clears the skeeters out. It's kind of neat at the well, you can see that in the video, but see the smoke lingering in the grass. Too much fun. Want to pay attention to this one, because as I was loading, a mosquito was crawling into the barrel for some strange reason. So I put a patch over, stuck a ball in, and now you're about to witness the fastest mosquito in the world. But she's only able to do the stunt once. One more time. Pays to bring the rubber boots, I'll tell you. Been raining a little bit here lately. Targets are underwater. Let's load in here. You peppered the shit out of that pretty good. 100 meters. So you hit the water, you probably See, pretty nice splash. Oh yeah, we nailed that one pretty good too. That's round ball, patch and round ball. 90 grains of 2F, 100 meters. Just ordinary old iron sights it came with. It's I'm not gonna complain about that. 200 meter target. Not a scratch. I noticed in the video that the balls were falling short of the target. It's just kind of understandable, I guess. But couldn't find the strikes on the ground. I'll see if I can find them on the way back. Oh well, I mean, hell, it's a flintlock with stock sights, so can't expect much more than that, I suppose.